Hello everyone and welcome to This Week in Stupid for the 14th of November 2020. After the startling success that YouTube had the previous 2 years with YouTube Rewind, it seems that they decided to take a break this year. Apparently 2020 has been different and it doesn't feel right for them to release another blockbuster YouTube Rewind. So they're taking a break. But apparently, according to YouTube, much of the good that happened in 2020 was created by me. And I found ways to lift people up and help them cope. I helped people cope and make them laugh. And I made a hard year genuinely better. Wow, thank you, YouTube. Thank you. I really appreciate it. Gotta say, I was looking forward for the It's a Gundam Pokimane drama to start in YouTube Rewind, the H3 Keemstar shenanigans that took place this year. But, you know, I guess there's always 2021 to see YouTube's blockbuster Rewind. Very excited to see that one. Now, before we proceed any further, I would like to make sure that the audience is made up of very progressive and forward-thinking individuals and not right-wing bigots. So I'm going to do a little bit of a purity test. I'm going to make sure that all the folks here are part of the polite society. And I'm going to ask you a question. Okay, what do you think about this? So an owner pleads for mystery neighbor to stop feeding her one stone pet cat Iris, who has kept piling on the pounds despite being on a strict diet. And the question is, do you think this is pet abuse? Okay, this cat is one stone and people keep feeding her. Is it pet abuse or is it not? And if you answer that it is, then you are a bigot because beauty comes at all sizes. And if you think that this is a problem, then clearly you are a fat shamer. And if you are a fat shamer, then you are a right-wing bigot. Learn to be more accepting of different body sizes. And honestly, there is no better time to learn on how to be acceptant and tolerant than under a Biden administration. Joseph Biden has been anointed as president-elect by Silicon Valley and the mainstream media in the name of Jack Dorsey and Zuckerberg and the holy MSNBC-CNN alliance, hallowed be their name. They have anointed him as president-elect. And we get to see this beautiful picture provided by Hillary Clinton with a very particular and interesting art style. It kind of reminds me of something like this. This particular art style reminds me of something, gives me vibes of something that I have seen before when I was a kid. I just don't remember what. I just can't put my finger onto what. But I gotta tell you, I am really, really hyped up about a Biden presidency. I mean, the man seems to be performing magic. He has only been president-elect for a couple of days, and the world is changing for the better. Like, look, just a couple of days after he won the election, apparently a Pfizer vaccine trial success signals a breakthrough in the pandemic battle. Do you see how amazing it is? Like literally just a couple of days after the election, this announcement was made. And many of the journalists have turned their frown into an upside down. Like for example, here you have Mr. Aaron Rupar pointing to a football gathering saying it's not ideal during a worsening pandemic. Now you can notice that this was at 11:45 p.m. on 11/7/2020. And literally, just a couple of minutes later, we see 12:16 p.m. It's party time outside the White House. Yes, absolutely it is. People are celebrating, everyone is happy, and I assume that the virus is happy as well. Because this is why people can now be outdoor, because the virus is out there partying, it's being distracted, it's not careful right now as to what is happening. So now people have taken advantage of this and are outside of the White House partying, which is why Aaron Rupert's frown is upside down. This is uplifting. This is good. This is civilized. This is harmful, by the way. Okay, like this. Don't do this. This is bad. Like, how dare you, sir? But this is good. This is good. Like, okay, so you need to understand the new normal. Impartial journalists, which only bring you the news and do not have any type of bias, have pissed their eyes when they found out who won the election. And apparently, according to ABC News, fireworks lit up the night sky over London, England, after Joe Biden was characterized to be the apparent winner of the presidential election. Now, some naysayers from the United Kingdom, people that have no common sense, they're peddling into conspiracy theories, would point out that the reason for the fireworks might have something to do with the Guy Fawkes celebration, which happens every single year around this time. But no, okay, you're wrong. You need to listen to ABC because ABC is always right. It is authoritative. So if ABC says that the Guy Fawkes celebration is actually about Joe Biden, who am I to disagree? Who am I? All right, like I see it in front of me. It's right up there on the screen. I cannot debunk this. I cannot refute this. So yes, I also expect that on the 31st of December, people around the world, except for China, because they have like a little bit different, the celebration comes at a different time. But like people around the world on the 31st of December are also going to celebrate Joe Biden's official nomination, right? So when the Electoral College meets and they all are, that's what it's going to happen. 31st, everyone is going to celebrate, your government as well, I guarantee it. All right? Only here on ABC News. So all in all, I mean, yeah, Joe Biden is the Wonder Man. I mean, he barely got president-elect, and all of a sudden, all of these things are happening. Like magical things are happening everywhere. Vaccines are being manufactured. Celebrations around the world, and more importantly, remember the fact that Portland, Oregon, used to have a little bit of civil unrest. Not a lot, but a little bit, and the fascist in chief, Donald Trump, suggested that he can send the National Guard over there, but Mayor Ted Wheeler responded in a very emotional and touching open letter, saying that he does not need the agentes federales to descend upon his city. He does not need the politics of division and demagoguery because the Portlanders are onto Trump. They have seen the reckless disregard for human life in his bumbling response to the COVID pandemic, and they know they've reached the conclusion that images of violence and vandalism, your only ticket to re-election. There is no place for looting, arson, or vandalism in his city. There is no room here for racismus, violencia, or those who wish to bring their ideology of hase into the community. Those who commit the criminal act will be apprehended and prosecuted under the law. Okay? Right? So, in other words, there is no need for the agentes federale while Trump is in office. They do not need politics of division. But now that we have Joe Biden, social media anointed president-elect, there is no more division. Now there is just unity and strength. And the National Guard has descended upon the protesters from Portland, which I understand they were peaceful, right? Like they were peaceful. But no, like now Joe Biden is president. So here we have it, folks. Do you see how the civil unrest just goes away? How can you not love him as a president? How can you not love a man that brings peace and tranquility to a place filled with controversy and turmoil like Portland? He immediately just pacified it. Like, he's not even in office. Like, imagine if things are this way now. Imagine when he actually steps and sits down in the White House, just how peaceful things are going to become. I mean, even Governor Cuomo says, politicians will take a different tone on COVID after the fascist in chief has been removed. So I'm really excited. I'm really excited to see what the future brings. Since the left is the party of unity and strength now, there's no more room for weak people like Bernie Sanders and Elizabeth Warren. Like, Bernie Sanders got cooked. He got cooked again. Look. Huh? Were you a Bernie supporter? We're tough shit. Biden is the Democratic Party now, okay? So, it's time for unity. It's time for unity. No more division, alright? No more nothing, because otherwise, the agentes federales descend upon you. So, get on with the program and stop complaining.
This Kim Delaney here has some new reporting on something that we talked about at the top of the hour, how the Trump administration is handling the transition with the incoming Biden team, or not handling it, we should say, to a certain extent. This time, it involves our intelligence community. Ken, what have you learned, sir? Oh, shit. Fuck. Okay.
Gotta say, that's one of the first times I have seen journalists actually become honest. But look at this one. This is even better. Like, this is a picture worth a thousand words. The Washington Post. Democracy dies in darkness. It's time to give the elites a bigger say in choosing the president. Oh, I absolutely agree. You know, like, when I look at the disenfranchised and the disempowered people in a society, I think of the elites. No one is better than the elites to handle things. I mean, you know, once every 4 years, puny mortals like myself, we go to the voting booths and we put a stamp. You know, but that is just way too much responsibility. That is just, like, way too burdensome. Why not the elites should handle this? You know, and by the way, like, I don't even need to know who the elites are. So just let them do whomever they may be. You know, and of course they need to be held unaccountable, because that's what makes a true elite. Like, I wouldn't want a fake elite to have the power, right? I mean, the elites are really, really competent. And they always know what they're doing. Do you know what the elites do best, though? Like, what they excel at? Spending your money. That's the relationship between you and them. You go to work, you spend 10, 11 hours working hard, and then you get a wage for your job well done. And part of that wage goes through taxes that the elites know how to spend. You don't know how to spend money. You're a dumbass. The elites, they know how to spend money. Just look at the House of Lords in the United Kingdom. They spend nearly £2 million on alcohol. Do you see how skillful they are? £2 million on alcohol and not one single cirrhosis, not a single hepatitis there. Like, that is just a job well done. This is what I want from the elites. To piss away, literally, the taxpayer money. To piss it away. You know what they were drinking? I bet ABC News is going to tell us. They were drinking, like, most of this money was being drunk when Joe Biden got elected. They were celebrating, weren't they? That's what they were doing. They were celebrating, huh? Just like the fireworks, and here they're celebrating here as well. This is just wonderful. I mean, look here, bigot. This is where your taxpayer money is going, right? I mean, you go to a woman of the night, a woman of low moral fiber, like my grandmother used to say, and you get entertainment. Well, now it's time to pay up, because it's hard times. It's hard times. You know, you may be out of a job, but so are other people, and we need to prioritize. We need to prioritize who gets money for being told to stay at home, and we need to start with the strippers, but not just any strippers, the ones of color. Okay, the ones of color, they're going to be eligible for federal COVID-19 release funds, sponsored by the taxpayer. Well, it's not really the taxpayer. I mean, like, we don't really care what the taxpayer has to say. It's the elite, right? Like, the elite is in charge of the money. He's the one enlightened enough and smart enough to make the financial decision. The taxpayer just has to pay, okay? And pray to the government that he might have a job in the next coming months. But other than that, let the elites handle it. So the strippers of color in Oregon are going to receive federal relief funds thanks to a local sex worker advocacy group. Well, I bet you wish you would have some advocacy group of your own. Didn't you, bigot? But why don't you have one? Why don't you have? You don't have one? Tough shit. You don't get any relief funds. You get to pay for them though, from the taxpayer. Nearly $600,000 was made available in a grant awarded to the organization Haymarket Pole Collective. Huh? You should have been a collective. See, the individual, not that much power. Not that much strength, individuality, horrible. Collective, power, strength, unity. With priority for black, indigenous, and transgender applicants. Why aren't you transgender yet? Why aren't you transgender yet? I told you. I told people they should transition. They didn't listen to me. Well, who's not getting the body now? Who's not getting the body now? What? Sucks to be you. Sucks to be a bigot. You need to transition so you can be in front of getting the taxpayer money. That you get, like, I look at the benefits, all right? Like, you get the collective fighting for you. You get, like, organizations and all of that just bending to your knee. All you have to do is just transition. Just do it. The grant will supply 75 workers with up to $1,600 in rent assistance, $500 towards utilities, and $150 for the internet. How can you live without internet? I mean, the essentials, right? 200 others will be given a bag containing coronavirus protective gear, a COVID test, gift cards, and other medical supplies. The Haymarket Pole Collective is the brainchild of PDX Stripper Strike, which was founded earlier this year by Kat Hollis and other women of the night seeking racial justice in the profession. Well, nothing tells me like racial justice like the taxpayer money. Just go to work, bigot, so you can pay up for racial justice. Now, a lot of people ask me, why do I love being a progressive person? What attracts me to the left? And the real answer is that the left, when presenting the world, they don't have to exaggerate. They don't have to use metaphors. They don't have to use hyperboles. They don't have to emblemish, because their version of reality is very accurate. They are presenting the world as is. Don't believe me? Watch this clip from CNN.
Welcome to the program, everyone. I'm Christiane Amanpour in London. This week, 82 years ago, Kristallnacht happened. It was the Nazis' warning shot across the bow of our human civilization that led to genocide against a whole identity. And in that tower of burning books, it led to an attack on fact, knowledge, history, and truth. After 4 years of a modern-day assault on those same values by Donald Trump, the Biden-Harris team pledges a return to norms.
See that? No editorializing, no emblemishing, just presenting the world as is. I didn't know that the Americans had it that hard for the last 4 years. I didn't know they were being persecuted like that in their own country. But now I do. Now I empathize with the Americans, and I understand why celebrities like Michael Shannon are finally speaking out. You know, it's only the millionaires and the billionaires that can guide people through this darkness, because they know better. And according to Michael Shannon, Trump supporters, it's their time to die now. You know, I'm really glad that the mainstream media like CNN aren't editorializing and presenting articles in a way that may incite violence. I mean, you know, like, the mainstream media is always keeping itself in check. Like, it realizes the huge burden and responsibility it has when presenting news to the public, so that, I don't know, they don't make the public think that Trump supporters would actually be Nazis and then get actual actors to write things like this. No, like, everything is good, you know, everything is nice. Because now it's time for healing and unity, as I understand it. By the way, do you know League of Legends? It's my favorite computer game. Best game ever. If you don't agree, you're wrong, all right? They're releasing a new champion. It's called the left-wing activist. The street activist of the left-wing. And this champion is going to fight with two weapons, as you notice. The weapon on the left is called healing, and the weapon on the right is called unity. And when it finds a fascist, it hits him with the unity, and it hits him with the healing. It's very beautiful, right? And here you have, in the real world, other people that says you can't heal or reform the GOP, who are now an extremist party. They have to be broken, burned down, and rebuilt. When Biden is in power, treat them like the active threats to democracy that they are. if those who committed crimes aren't punished, then they will be more emboldened. Yes. By the way, a study shows that when people get their way, the more likely it is for them to call for healing and unity. When they get their way, it's all of a sudden, oh, it's time for healing, it's time for unity. How do we heal people? By having a tribunal of truth and reconciliation. By going after the lawyers and the people who collaborated with the previous administration. This is how you heal. This is how you unite people and make sure that everyone gets behind the same message. And I understand that I am Romanian, okay? So my English isn't very good, but when I say heal, I mean like heal as in healing, okay? Like mending wounds. I don't mean heal like you tell a dog. It's like sit next to me, obey, be quiet, heal, heal boy, heal. No, that's not what I mean. Okay, that's not right. I mean as in healing, all right, healing. And also, you get to notice this gentleman, Don Wilson, who is a New York Times bestseller. He's a victim. Just so you can understand how deranged the people on the right are, all right? Like, they do not understand that he's got a check mark and he is allowed to make inflammatory stuff. But you as a peasant, you, a member of the plebeians, are not allowed to say anything in return, because if you do, then remember, your IP can be traced, even if you use a fake emails. And there are other ways to trace as well. And he also had a private investigator, so be careful with your language. Okay, like, look, a lot of people just don't understand this, so I'll simplify it for you. Remember when you read those books with the medieval time, where you have like a member of the aristocracy just going on a horse and looking with disgust towards the peasants and going like, pugh, you know, at the peasant. The peasant is not allowed to do the same. Like, the peasant lives by different rules. He is not of a noble blood. He is not of high born. So how can we tell the noble blood from the peasantry? And the answer is with this, the check mark. Okay, it's very simple. This is actually what it means. It's blue blood, right? It's like the blue nobility. Right? The nobility has blue blood. This is a mark of prestige. It is a mark of pedigree. And it shows that this person is better than you. So you need to shut up. Now you need to heal. Now you need to heal. Okay? Now, let me help you think. Okay? Because a lot of you have this difficulty in thinking. And this is what I do. Alright? If you go on social media, bigot, you will notice that a lot of the things that the president is posting is getting like this little blue thing that says this claim about election fraud is being disputed, right? And this is how you know how to think. Like, you go to the Bezoses of the world, you go to the Jack Dorseys of the world, and if you don't know how to think, they will help you out. I mean, there are people that are willing to help you. All you have to do is to accept them. And if you were to take a time machine and go back into the past, you'd notice that Twitter was always there to help people. Like, for example, here with your boy Socrates. I don't know, man. I'm beginning to think that maybe the ruling elite aren't as wise as they claim to be. Like, learn more about how Socrates is corrupting the youth of Athens. See, providing context is very important. Like, the Trojan priest, Laocoon, we must not bring the wooden horse into the city. I fear Greeks, even those bearing gifts, we must burn it. Learn how the generous Greek peace offerings is safe and secure. Hold up, I think the Fire Nation was here. Only flying bison can reach Air Temple. The Fire Nation cannot. Get the facts here. We got here Ron Paul from 2002. Why the fuck are we invading Iraq? There is no proof that Saddam had any involvement in 9/11 or that he has weapons of mass destruction. Learn more about Saddam Hussein's involvement in 9/11 and weapons of mass destruction. See, like, there are people willing to help you out. The context is there. Just read it. Just understand it, you bigot. Like, look, Paul Revere. The British are coming. Learn how British taxes are beneficial to society. Galileo Galilei, the earth revolves around the sun. This claim is disputed by theology experts. Kamala Harris, our country is facing a number of crises, a global pandemic, a recession, systemic racism, and the climate crisis, and I am ready to roll up our sleeves and get to work now. This claim about the existence of systemic racism is disputed. Wait, hold up. This is a... Hey, who gave me a fake meme? Who gave it? Which one of you did it? Do you think I would not spot it in time? Who gave me fake news? Okay, no, like, this shouldn't be here. I am sorry. Like, this blue thing, like, should not exist here. I really apologize. Now, finally, let's end this with a high note. Let's show a great invention that people in the West have came up with. It is a hugging station. It is a place where grandparents can hug their grandkids using what is now called a hugging station. So I'm going to show you some very emotional images. If you are a very sensitive person, then I suggest you get a tissue because you're going to water your eyes after this, right? So here you got it. I want people to remember that this is normal. This is the new normal. This is perfectly fine. This is how it should. This is now normal. This is normal. This is acceptable. This is okay. The new normal. The new normal is here to stay. I just want to say that I wish I lived in America because they are so lucky to have a man like Fauci at the helm who says that America has an independent spirit, but now it is time to do what you're told. Smother that spirit, Fauci. Smother it with a pillow. Smother it. It is in the way of progress. No, but seriously, like, what is this spirit useful for? When did this spirit ever do anything for you? The man in the government does things for you. He gives you welfare. He puts food on your table. Do what you're told. American spirit. Nonsense. Absolute hogwash. And apparently here are the guidelines of what you need to do if you live in California now. And really can't help yourself but to be an asshole and throw one of those biological weapons, which is called Thanksgiving. Well, at least follow these guidelines, okay? No more than 3 households together at a time. Gatherings must be outside 2 hours or less. On the clock. On the clock. Like, more than 120 minutes. And in my opinion, you should be arrested. But then you can also only use restrooms if they are being frequently sanitized. And most importantly, singing, chanting, and shouting is going to be strongly discouraged. And you can see the ultimate compassion of the people in charge. I mean, they're not going to arrest you over this. They're just going to discourage it. Which kind of makes me realize I shout a lot, don't I? Holy crap. I might be one of these bioweapons. I need to tone my voice down. Because this is the new normal. Trademark. New normal. Trademark. Brand it. Sell it. Make it acceptable. If you like my show, okay, you can really help me out. Because I'm going to eBay now. So, super chats, they help out. I have a link to a PayPal in the comment section. And there's also a Subscribestar. But what you can do is to share this around, okay? The algorithm doesn't like This Week in Stupid. Sharing it around would help me a lot, and I appreciate it. All right, Christmas is coming, difficult times all around, and I really appreciate the fact that you choose to spend a little bit of your life watching this episode, and I hope I managed to bring a smile on your face, and I managed to entertain you a little bit throughout this horrible year, which has been 2020. Thank you guys for listening, and I will see you all in the comment section. We'll be right back.